Hi everybody, it's Bob Boob with my coffee pot. So this is coffee and boob time. All right, I put it out there a couple weeks ago. If there was anything you wanted me to do videos on, reach out to me. Well, there was one that a lot of you have asked about, but I had to put a little bit of thought and effort into this one. The question is being asked, Boob, is there a bubble? Is the bubble gonna burst? You know, how long is this market going to last? All right, obviously guys, I don't have a crystal ball. Man, if you ever find a real estate crystal ball, I don't care what auction or yard sale, buy it, whatever you pay for it, I'll reimburse you, I promise you. But anyhow, till we have a real estate crystal ball, obviously I can't predict the future, but let's follow some, this is boob sense, all right? When we had the COVID break, all the real smart people were saying that when we came out of the COVID break, it was gonna be recession, depression, real estate was gonna be just bad. Of course, the opposite happened. All the smart people, they didn't really know what they were talking about. It ended up being one of the best real estate markets that we've had in, 50 years. Certainly my 34 years, it's the best, strongest market that I've ever seen. So with that said, you can look on websites. Some smart people know sometimes, some smart people don't know. But okay, follow me on my logic here. This is my boob logic. All right, you're either gonna stay where you're currently at or you're not. Is there any other option? Or you're gonna maybe die and go to heaven. At least I hope you go to heaven. But you're either staying where you're at or you're gonna buy. Now, if you're staying, you're either renting or you own, or maybe you're living with your parents. If you're living with your parents, it's actually not a really bad deal. Just stay with your parents, keep putting away every month what you would pay for rent or a mortgage somewhere. Tell you what, that's the best deal you got there. But like the rest of us, if you either own your own current home or you're renting, this is where it gets a little more difficult. If you stay renting, all right, at the end of a year, 2 years, 3 years, however long you continue to rent, you do need to keep a roof over your head. So renting's not bad, but what I'm saying is, at the end of that period of time, you just have a stack of rent receipts. You don't have any equity, it's not your house, you got to deal with the landlord, what he or she will let you do, not do. Can you have pets, can you not have pets? Again, whatever your situation is, and then rents continue to rise. Actually, I've said this now, if you have a pet, it is easier to find a house to buy than it is to find a house to rent where the landlords will allow pets, especially if you have a dangerous breed dog. It's just crazy out there. Okay, so the second option, you either rent and you can just stay renting and you really don't have anything to show for it at the end of a couple year period. Now, if you know you're gonna be leaving in a short period of time, renting probably makes more sense than buying with this purchase expenses and the selling expenses. I'm sorry, I'm gonna get around to the bubble here then. This takes a little bit, this is how my little three brain cell works here. Okay, so if you currently own and you stay, well, if there's either a bubble or not a bubble, it's gonna affect you the same. You may just have a less or more expensive house because not everybody is selling and buying a more expensive home. Some people are selling and buying a less expensive home. So the bubble is gonna affect you no matter what if you currently own real estate. What I find though, that right now rates have been moving up. As of the recording of this, it's running right around 5.5, 6.5. So can I say 6%? All right, now you can pull out an amortization schedule, but if you put $100,000 in there at 6% for a 30-year mortgage, it's like $5.99. So can I just say $6 per thousand? So about $600 for every 100 grand that you borrow. So if you buy a $300,000 house, it's gonna cost you 1,800 bucks a month plus the taxes and insurance on that property. That's a fixed interest rate. There are some variable loans out there, but just for our conversation purposes, we'll say you get a fixed rate, you're spending $1,800 a month on a $300,000 mortgage. So let's say in a year or two, there is a bubble, real estate prices drop. Well, you should be able to still afford that payment if your income doesn't change. Now, if your income changes, then of course you may have to sell. But at that point right there, the market has already increased by however long that you've had it. And of course, it's also your home. So if you find homes that are in nice areas, school districts that are popular, I personally like homes that maybe are a tad dated that you can go in and do cosmetic work and fix them up, but the homeowners have taken care of them. They have good roofs, good wiring, furnaces, you know, those sort of things. Look for things that with the home that you purchase, is it good for resale? Like, is it a big house with a small yard? That's not necessarily good for resale. Is it on a really busy street that not really many people want to live on? You might want to think about that. But if it's in a good neighborhood where it's easy to sell, good school district, decent sized yard, got some parking, nice sized home, you know, really the economic market's probably going to hold that as best as anybody can then. But at least you still have your home, it's yours, you can fix it up and you have that. So all this to say, guys, I truly don't know if the bubble's going to burst, what's going to happen. All I know is in North Central Pennsylvania, where I do real estate, things have always chugged along pretty good, right around a 2, 3, 4% interest. Been significantly higher than that the last 2 years. But even if things slowed down and history repeats itself, of course, no guarantee for that. Got to put all these disclosures in here in case somebody tries to use this video to sue me later. But the idea is that if history continues to repeat itself, our area is still just casually, easy for me to say, increases around 2, 3, 4% per year. Then it may not jump like the 10, 15% that we've seen over the last couple of years. So I'm not trying to talk you into buying. I'm not trying to talk you into staying renting. I'm just saying, don't let other people's fears dictate whether you should purchase or sell. Analyze your own situation. Analyze the market. Talk to a good realtor. You can talk to me. You can talk to other good realtors out there. But that's my thoughts on it. So there you go. I don't really have anything else to add other than I know this was a little bit longer video than I normally like to do for a weekly update. But this is a pretty deep subject, and we could probably talk about it for another hour or two then. If you do have more questions on it, please reach out to me. My cell phone's 570-220-0741. It's probably at the top or the bottom of the screen here somewhere. But yeah, that's it. So I'm gonna go get some more coffee. Thank you. Have a good day. Appreciate your time. Bye-bye.